We want to determine the area bounded by the two functions f of x equals x and g of x equals x cubed. I think one of the most important things to do on this type of problem is to graph it on your graphing calculator or even by hand, because the x coordinates of the points of intersection will help us determine our limits of integration, and we also have to know which function is on top and which function is on the bottom in the interval. So the ultimate goal here is to determine the area of this bounded region here, as well as the area of this bounded region here. What's different about this question is notice on the left, the cubic function is on top and the line is on the bottom, but on the right, the line is on top and the cubic function is on the bottom. This means we'll have to have two different definite integrals to determine the area of the entire bounded region. Because we have the graph, we can see the x-coordinate of this point of intersection is -1, and then we have another intersection point at x equals 0, and then at x equals 1. So we'll have to integrate from -1 to 0 and then from 0 to 1. Now if you didn't have a good enough graph to determine the x coordinates of these points of intersections, what we'd have to do is set these two functions equal to each other and solve for x. And I'm going to go ahead and show that. We'd set x equal to x cubed. Let's go ahead and move this x to the right side. So we'd have 0 equals x cubed minus x. Then we could factor and solve. Factor out x, we'd have x squared minus 1, and then we'd factor again. So difference of squares. So there are three solutions to this equation. We have x equals 0, x equals negative 1, and x equals positive 1. Again, notice how these values match the x coordinates of the points of intersection we see here on the graph. Let's go ahead and set up our two definite integrals. Other than determining the x coordinates of the points of intersections, when we set up an integral, we have to have the top function minus the bottom function. So the area of the entire bounded region will be the definite integral from -1 to 0 of x cubed minus x. Again, that's the top function minus the bottom function plus the definite integral from 0 to 1. But now the top function is going to be the line, so we'll have x minus x cubed. Now I do want to mention that for this example, these two regions do have the same area because of the symmetry, so we could just take twice one of these integrals, but it's not always going to be the case where these two regions would have the exact same area. So I'm going to go ahead and show this using both definite integrals. So here we'll have x to the fourth divided by 4 minus x squared divided by 2. We'll evaluate this at 0 and negative 1. And here we'll have x squared divided by 2 minus x to the fourth divided by 4. We'll evaluate this at 1 and 0. So when x is 0, these are both 0. And then when x is negative 1, this is going to be positive 1/4 minus 1/2. And then over here, when x is 1, we'll have 1/2 minus 1/4. And then when x is 0, this will be 0 again. So 1/4 minus 1/2 is negative 1/4, but we're subtracting that, so it's 1/4. Plus, here we have 1/2 minus 1/4, which is also 1/4. So we have a total of 2/4, or 1/2 of a square unit for the area of this entire bounded region. So I can't emphasize enough how important it is to have a graph of the two functions, not only to determine the limits of integration, but also to determine which function is on top and which function is on bottom. I hope you found this helpful.